Hi everyone, my name is Raghvendra Kamath. I'm an illustrator and designer from India. I use Twitter for my work and try to help the team in testing and documentation and maintaining the website twitterartist.org. Today we are going to talk about how we built a community forum for Twitter. Let's talk a bit about the Krita community, Krita and its community. Krita is a digital painting application, and it started as K Image Shop in 1999, and then it was renamed to Krita in 2002. Initially, it tried to be an general purpose image manipulation software, and then since 2009, the team shifted focus to digital painting. Since then, Krita is immensely improving with each release, and today it is a solid contender in the market, rivaling with other giants in the industry. Each release of Krita adds more and more number of users to its community. The current guesstimate of the Krita users base is about 5 to 6 million users worldwide. Its community consists of a diverse set of users, from amateur painters to professionals, from school kids to art students, users from Windows, Linux, macOS, Android, users speaking different languages. It targets the concept artists, nail painters, comic book artists, game developers, etc. History and existing community channels. Krita is powered by volunteers from the community. Existing channels and community spaces were started by these volunteers. The developers do a wonderful job of being present in every space as possible. The initial community was based on Linux users and free software enthusiasts on IRC mailing list and KDE sub forums. The first release, which was ready for professional use, was in 2012, and since then Krita has established its presence on various social media websites and forums like DeviantArt, Tumblr, Twitter, Reddit, Facebook, etc. Some of the accounts are officially managed by the developers, and some are managed by the volunteers. When the Windows version was released in 2004, Krita started getting more and more users from the Windows side, and it is also from where our largest user base comes from. This added to the increased user interactions in the existing community spaces. Krita community also has adopted new mediums for the new mediums. For example, Krita has Instagram page and then also an unofficial Discord channel run by volunteers. Then what we learned and what was required with the increasing number of users. We also got increasing number of questions and users seeking help, and also a lot of users seeking help. We also noticed that there are more and more generic user support questions which were piling upon, which were spilling onto the Bugzilla. All the existing spaces, Reddit, Twitter, etc., saw increasing duplicate questions, and even if we prepared some FAQ page, it was not that effective. The developers do an excellent job in answering all the questions wherever they encounter them, but it affects the time they spend on the development. There can't also be a disconnect between the users and the developers. We really needed a way to solve most of these user questions easily. So in 2018, we tried to solve this with a website modeled on Stack Exchange, where users will post their questions and also help other users with their questions. This website was called ask.krita.org. The questions can be could be upvoted so that most frequent questions would be at the top. Initially, the team seeded the website with some frequently asked questions and also answers to them. But this website was this website lasted for about a year until May 2019. We learned that apart from regular developers and few passionate volunteers, nobody was staying on the website to help others out. There was also no engagement factor, and users didn't have any incentive to spend time on it. Few months later, during an IRC discussion, the Krita maintainer Hal Arendt had an idea of having a community website similar to Blender. It was called blenderartist.org. So I volunteered to set up and host this website. I was not a developer, so I asked my friend Ameya to help me in the process. We researched a bit about Blender Artist. It was using Discourse software to host the community. But unlike typical Discourse community, it had few plugins which aided in highlighting the art aspect of the community. This is the factor which holds the users to the website. Users get to share their artwork and users get to share their artwork made with Krita and have a discussion about it. The feedback from the fellow artists and Krita enthusiasts encourages them to return to the website. It is kind of like a mixture of Reddit and forum combined into one. We released KritaArtist.org on October 2019. Setting up the website was not that hard. The person running BlenderArtist also answered some of our questions about the setup. The website has been working great until now. It has around 10k users registered with about 1,000 active users per month. There have been around 85,000 posts in these last 2 years. You can call it a success, if I say so. Yeah. So how it is hosted? Let's see the setup. We host the website on a Hetzner VPS. There are two servers. The server has the Discourse instance. A Docker, the official Docker image is used to install the Discourse. The second server hosts a mail in a box. It is a utility to host your own mail server. Using this, we send the admin email, system email, and handle the DNS, etc. The Discourse server has 80 GB of space and 4 GB of RAM. We are running out of space since the forum is a bit heavy on the image side. Users do like to share a lot of images and artworks and etc. And they don't resize. It is often high resolution artworks. So yeah. Now we can see how it has helped us. Discourse is a robust forum software. We found that it is designed really well, keeping in mind all the possibilities and scenarios that a community needs. It has checks and limitations on new users to mitigate spams. For example, a new user can't repeatedly make posts, or he can't edit his post after a period of time. It also has a wide variety of plugins. There is a thriving community support for it. There are various features like badges, and you get a badge for spending some time on the forum or helping somebody. If you get some amount of likes, you get a badge. There are also likes for the posts, etc. It helps in keeping the user engaged in the forum. It is also very feature rich from the moderation point of view. where you can like it has features such as slow mode, where you can contain a heated debate and by limiting the number of by limiting the time to post subsequent posts. Flagging system, which helps user to keep the community clean, also helps the keep the community clean. And as a user spends more time on the forum, they will be given some more powers to become semi-moderator in the forum. Feature-wise, it is really well thought out and designed really well. Whenever we wanted something, we saw that discourse had it in some way or the other. It is not rigid by any chance. It is very flexible. Feature-wise, it has really helped us regarding actual user support. We have redirected most of our user support to this forum. We also have made the forum as an important step in the bug reporting process, wherein we encourage users to check the FAQ first and then ask questions on this forum in case they don't find an answer. They don't find an answer in the FAQ, they can post questions on this forum. Some users prefer to report things on the forum and then they are guided to the Bugzilla in case if it is an actual bug, although not completely, but it has reduced some load from Bugzilla. User questions are categorized accordingly. They can also mark an answer as solved. It helps for other user to find the answer easily. The forum has also a robust search feature, which helps in finding similar questions and problems that some other users have faced earlier. We have a category called artist testing and feedback. New betas are tested and users provide feedback in the forum post. New brushes, blend modes, etc. are discussed and developed in collaboration. For example, Ramon, our in-house artist, created some excellent charcoal brushes with the input from the community. Developers were able to get good feedback about the new RGBA brushes, which mimic traditional impasto effect. Our new resource management system also got initial feedback and testing from the community. Some people like the height. There is a blending mode called height in other software. Some people really like that, and there was a post about it, and there was collaborative research and development. Developers were able to implement a better version of this. This category keeps the developers and users in touch, and it helps in quickly getting feedback regarding new features and releases. Talking about feature requests, we do have a dedicated category for feature requests. This category has seen some heated debate on the forum. Artists write posts about the features they need. Other users chime in and discuss the advantages and disadvantages of their feature. For example, a feature for some users might be a hindrance for some other. So the features get feature requests get balanced scrutiny, and it also helps in making it inclusive so that it solves everyone's need. Developers do chime in and specify what is possible and what may not be possible, or what is priority, and if some feature request is not a priority or out of scope, then they can discuss that in the post itself. At the end of the debate, most of the time, developers get a clear view of what is expected by the user, what are all the requirements, etc. So it is not just about software development, but it is about artistic development. It is also about artistic development. While we have category for feedback and testing, we also have categories for artworks. This is an important category. It receives almost triple the amount of posts as compared to the support category. Users post their artwork, post their artwork and get critiques and feedback from the fellow users. There are artworks by professionals as well as beginners, and users try to help each other in getting better at painting. Apart from the artwork category, we have a contest and art duel category. While there is not much happening in this category, but we recently hosted an official Krita art contest with a tablet maker who sponsored some prizes. Users were given time to create artwork with a specified theme, and after the deadline, the category was locked. The results were declared on the official Krita website. In conclusion, overall, Krita Artist has been a wonderful asset for us. In addition to the traditional social media website, it has really become a dedicated dedicated place where users and developers come together to make Krita better. We have a lot of heated debates, discussions. Developers get to know the demands of the users better, while users also get to know the developers and what's their point of view, know their point of view about a feature. We have posts such as I want this feature, copy this feature from this software, etc. But when other users chime in and other users explain their opinion about the feature, the features get improved, and maybe we get a better alternative from there. So we expect it to it helps the development process, and it helps to get a rapid feedback from the users. We also some of the developers provide app images to test. The users test that app image and immediately answer the questions or report any bugs in that app image. Then the developer goes back and solves this, and again shares an app image. So this cycle goes on until it is until the feature is foolproof. We expect this community to grow more and probably aid in handling the needs of the ever-growing Krita community. I would really urge other creative applications in KDE Fold to host this type of community with the help of Discourse software. Other creative applications like KDE and like etc. can have their own Discourse community. It helps in getting in touch with the users, in addition to the traditional social media and other mediums. This is a great space. Lastly, an advice I would give to anybody willing to host such site is that be patient while moderating the heated debates. Draft a COC right from the start, or if you are hosting on the KDE infrastructure, then it is well and good. You are bound by the KDE COC. Use a VPS provider, which can give you a flexibility in increasing the storage space when required. For example, now we are experiencing some storage crunch. That helps a lot. I think I finished my slide earlier so that I can. It's earlier so that I have some time to give a demo of the website to all of you guys. Before that, I'm open to questions as well. You can post the questions. I'll prepare the website to give you a demo of the artworks and etc.
Okay, so are you doing questions now, or are you? Do you want to do the demo first?
I think I'll show the website first, and then I'll take the questions.
Okay, then go ahead.
Yeah. I think, yeah, can you see the screen?
Yes.
Okay. So, like I said, we have the top category is support and advice, where people can share questions, and each questions, like the other community members answer the question, and people can also mark a question as a solution. Then which can later be people who Google stuff will be landing here directly due to good SEO, etc. And the main highlight of the forum is all the artwork that we have. It is a all these wonderful artworks are in one place, and people, you have this like button, and people giving feedback to you. So it keeps the user on the forum itself. Like there is some feedback for the users as well, so that they keep coming back on the website, and while they are on the website, they see the questions, and that in turn leads to like more user support for the other users. Then we had a art contest which was sponsored by Huion. So Kiki and the mascot of the Huion tablet. There was a theme. So there are also developer questions. People who want to code, like hack on Krita, come and ask questions about how to set up Krita, etc. So it is basically a one-stop place for the community, and it binds everything together. So. I can take the questions now. I guess we do have some time for it.
Yeah, we still have time, and we have one question so far, and this one comes from Paul. He asks, yeah. How does Discourse compare to maintaining a mailing list? Is it more work or less?
I have not maintained a mailing list, so I can't compare the maintenance burden to a mailing list. But feature-wise, it blows mailing list out of the water, so you can't compare. It's like comparing apples and oranges. Basically, you have the ability to write in markdown format, drag and drop images in your post, have a poll right there in the thread. If you have an artwork and or a feature or a UI mockup, you can have a poll which one the users like. Then there are notifications for likes and everything. It has more user engagement than a mailing list. Mailing list has its space, and Discourse also can be used as a mailing list. For example, I said we have a server for handling the mail part of the Discourse. So it sends digests and daily mails notifications through mail, so that users who are not on the website read the mail and come back on the website. But there is also a feature called reply by mail. We have not enabled it yet, but you can enable it and it will work as though you are using a mailing list. So it's two-in-one kind of a thing. You can say that mailing list is a feature of discourse. So yeah, any other questions? I can't hear you.
Of course, I have to unmute myself. I am a professional, yeah. After all. in the demo, you have showed that we had an art contest using Discourse, yeah. Right? We do have also those from time to time, particularly, I think yesterday it was announced that we'll be having another round of for the wallpaper, for the default wallpaper for Plasma. So you think Discourse is a good place to have such a contest on?
Sure. You can host a contest, and the category itself gives you features such as you can lock the keep a deadline to the category and lock it up, after which users can't post anything on it. And there is also a feature so that users can like a post, and it gets sorted accordingly. The number of likes brings some post above and some post below. There is also you can also do discussions. Maybe some improvements are needed to the, for example, the wallpaper may need some improvement. Users can edit the post, and add the new image, etc. So in for the art contest thing, it works well, and you can definitely hold an art contest on such forum.
Okay, thank you very much. No other questions have popped up, so we'll leave it up here. Thank you very much for the presentation. I'm sure we'll be looking into our own discourse in the future if possible. Thanks.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay.